So this is the classification of bearings. Bearings are primarily classified into two types. One is rolling contact bearing, and second type is sliding contact bearing. So rolling contact bearing, also called as anti-friction bearing or simply ball bearing. So again, this rolling contact bearing is subdivided into some other types. So let's start with rolling contact bearing. So this is the rolling contact bearing, where contact is by rollers. These are spherical balls inserted inside to avoid the friction. And then deep groove ball bearing. So these are ball bearings with the deep groove. So such type of bearings are called deep groove ball bearings. And after that, we have cylindrical roller bearing. So cylindrical roller bearing, the roller is of cylindrical shape that you can see here. Cylindrical roller bearing. And then we have angular contact bearing. The angular contact bearing is designed on the direction of thrust acting. So thrust acting here is vertically, so the bearing is in the middle. So when the thrust is acted from the side, so the bearing is designed so that the thrust can be taken care of. This is the angular contact bearing. And the next one is self-aligning bearing. The name itself is self-aligning. So these are the bearing which align by itself. When the shaft is little bent or some radial movement we required, in that case self-aligning bearings are preferred. And the next type is taper roller bearing. So this is the taper roller bearing, where the bearing is inserted little taper depending on the requirement. So such type of bearing is called taper roller bearings. We have one more classification that is also called sliding contact bearing, plane bearing, journal bearing or slew bearing. These are one another same. So in this we have two types. So let's see first of all what are these bearings are. So this is the slew bearing or journal bearing. So here this center shaft is called as journal. Please remember this, the center shaft is called as journal, and we have oil filled at the clearance. At this portion, oil is filled. And then hosting, we have an oil inlet and bearing liners. So this constitutes a journal bearing or also plane bearing. And next we have hydrodynamic bearings. So hydrodynamic bearing, we can see the hydrodynamic bearing. So we have some stages in hydrodynamic lubrication. So at rest, journal and bearing are in solid contact, and at the start, oil film start to develop in between the journal and bearing, and after the start the oil film will grow, and at running speed the oil film will produce a clearance between journal and bearing, and this is the pressure of the oil film at the running. So this is the hydrodynamic bearing. That means there is a already oil film present. Coming to hydrostatic bearing, it is similar to hydrodynamic bearing, but only thing is the oil is supplied by a pump. So this pump helps to pressurize the oil inside the journal and bearing. So journal used to be at rest when there is no rotation, and when rotation starts, the oil film will develop in the clearance between journal and bearing so as to avoid the friction. So this type of bearing is called hydrostatic bearing. The main difference is we have a oil supply in the hydrostatic bearing. So here it creates a lubrication film by the help of external source or pump.